Hello there. Welcome to our science demonstration today. I'm PA, sometimes they call me Pastor Allen, but today I'm Professor Allen, and we're going to talk about a really fun demonstration today. We know that most elements under normal circumstances have three different stages that they can exist in. They can be a solid, they can be a liquid like water, or they can be a vapor like steam. Sometimes as water can be a solid like ice, it can be water, liquidy, and it could be steam if the element, or this molecule rather, is between the temperatures of 0 and 100 degrees Celsius, or 32 degrees and 212 degrees Fahrenheit, then we know it stays within a water state. If it goes above those limits, it's in steam, and if it goes below, it freezes. But today we're going to talk about something different, a different kind of molecule, not the water molecule, but carbon dioxide. CO2, one atom of carbon with two atoms of oxygen put together. And carbon dioxide has a very unique property, and that is that when it is compressed and made cold enough in the right conditions, it becomes a solid. But that solid, that block of what we call today dry ice, doesn't go from being dry ice to a vapor or to carbon dioxide gas by going through a liquid state. It immediately moves from being the solid into a vapor state, and we call that the process of sublimation. Now, carbon dioxide is very cold when it's in a frozen state or a solid state. In fact, it has to be 109 degrees below zero Fahrenheit, or about 78.5 degrees below zero centigrade, to be frozen. And I'm going to show you what some of it looks like, and you don't want to touch it because it's very cold, but I have some here in a container, and this container, as we see here, we have a block of some of it in a newspaper here. We're going to take it out of the newspaper, and as I hold it up here to the camera so you can see it, you see how it's letting off steam. And what it is, it's really not hot steam. It's actually the carbon dioxide that's going into the air, and so I'm going to break this up a little bit here because I don't need it all for our experiment. And we'll wrap this other piece up. Remember, it's 109 degrees below zero, so the paper insulates it and keeps me from getting hurt, but you can use gloves. But I'm holding it with the tongs, and I'm going to put it in the glass of the tube of water. And it looks like it's boiling, but notice that the vapor, as it comes out, goes over and down the sides of the glass, and that's because carbon dioxide is heavier than the nitrogen and the oxygen in our atmosphere. It's like taking some water, and I can put some water in a little cup here, and then I'm going to take some oil that I got from this lamp that has collard oil in it, and I'm going to pour it in here, and it mixes just for a moment, and then we see that what happens is that the oil separates and it floats on top of the water because the oil is lighter than the water. Now what we're going to do, we're going to take a little piece of cloth that's about an inch wide, and we've soaked this cloth in soapy water, and we're going to wring it around the end here, and then we're going to open up our cloth. And we're going to take it and we're going to lay it on the edge, and we're just going to pull it back and see what happens. Look at that. What do you think of that? We're making a little bubble, and that bubble can move around and be a little wobbly, but what's happening is as the carbon dioxide is diffusing, it's filling up this bubble now, just like when you blow the little bubbles, and there it went. As a child, you made bubbles out of the little blow rings, and we'll try this again and see how it goes this time. And here it's going up and going up. Isn't that something? And this can get quite big, or it can sort of stay here, but when it bursts, you would think of all this liquid or something falling out of it, but that isn't what happens. It's filled with the carbon dioxide and it just diffuses right like that. See how simple that was? And we'll do that one more time and see if we can get it to do that for us. And I'm going to take my tongs here and just check my carbon dioxide. Make sure it's still in there. Yep, doing its job. And now we're going to run this over top again for our third trip through. And notice it's coming up. Now this time I'm going to push just a little bit here, and for a while you can do this. It will stay like that and then it disappears. Try one more time. We may have to run it around. We will. And there we go. Now this bubble is not going to rise quite as much because a lot of our carbon dioxide has already come out of that ice block that we put in there, and it doesn't have as much volatility as it did at first, but you can see it's rising. It's making quite a beautiful little bubble. Now what are some spiritual lessons that we can learn from this kind of an experience? Well, one thing we can learn is that because of this process of sublimination, the carbon dioxide does not pass through the intermediate state of being a liquid. It goes directly from being the solid or the dry ice form into the vapor of carbon dioxide. And as Christians, when we become a Christian, when we accept Jesus Christ, we don't have to go through an intermediate stage between being a sinner and being a saint. As soon as we come to Jesus Christ, we are accepted in Him. In fact, in Romans chapter 3, in verses 21 through 26, the Bible says, "But now the righteousness of God without the law is manifested, being witnessed by the law and the prophets, even the righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ unto all and upon all them that believe, being justified freely by His grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, to declare, I say, at this time, His righteousness, that He might be just and the justifier of him which believeth in Jesus." And then in the book Gospel Workers by Ellen White on page 466, she says, "The moment you surrender yourself wholly to Him in simple faith, Jesus accepts you and encircles you in His arms of love." In Signs of the Times, March 17th, 1890, she says, "As soon as you surrender wholly to Christ, He will accept you." That's Signs of the Times, March 17th, 1890. Now there's another lesson that we can learn from this process. When we put the dry ice in, it just began to bubble violently. In fact, let's just put a little more in it. We'll take some out, and again, you are to be very careful if you're ever handling dry ice. You can get a frostbite from it very easily. And we'll put a little more in here, and you see it starts to move around a little bit more there now. And we can't stop this process. It's going to happen. But in the same way, when we become a Christian, the process of sharing our faith is going to happen, and it can't be stopped. In Acts chapter 4, the apostles have been commanded not to preach or speak in the name of Jesus. But Peter and John answered and said unto them, "Whether it be right in the sight of God to hearken unto you more than unto God, judge ye, for we cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard." Acts chapter 4, verses 18 through 20. In Luke chapter 19, when Jesus rode into Jerusalem triumphantly, there were those who were crying, "Hosanna! Hosanna to the Son of God! Hosanna to the highest!" And there were those who came and told His disciples, said some of the Pharisees among the multitude said unto Him, "Master, rebuke Thy disciples." And He, that is Jesus, answered and said unto them, "I tell you that if these should hold their peace, the stones would immediately cry out." And so, beloved, as Christians, when we come into the faith of Christ, we are compelled to share His love. And this is one of the first signs that we truly are a Christian, that we want to share His love with others. Well, thank you for taking time to be with us for this little science demonstration today. And I hope it's helped you to understand a little bit more about coming to Jesus just as you are, that He will accept you, and then you can share your faith then with others. Till next time, may God bless you lots and lots and lots.